Hallelujah. This morning, I want to talk to you briefly on the topic, prayer, the key to fulfilling your purpose. Prayer, the key to fulfilling your purpose. Prayer, the key to fulfilling your purpose. And I want to begin my message by saying, a purpose discovered is not a purpose fulfilled. A purpose discovered is not a purpose fulfilled. If you have discovered your purpose in life, doesn't mean that purpose is fulfilled. Oh yes. Oh yes. And it is one thing to have a purpose, and it is another thing to fulfill that purpose. It is one thing to have a purpose, and it is another thing to do what? To fulfill that purpose. Now, when you read the Bible in the book of Colossians chapter 4 verse 17. Colossians chapter 4 verse 17. Apostle Paul says something, and I love that statement, very powerful. He said, and say to Archippus, take heed to the ministry which thou hast received in the Lord, that thou fulfill it. And don't forget this statement. It is one thing to receive a purpose, and it is another thing to fulfill that purpose. Don't forget that statement. Apostle Paul told Archippus, he said, take heed to the ministry which thou hast received in the Lord, that thou fulfill it. Let me see how the NLT version put it. NLT. He said, tell Archippus. He said, I didn't say NIV. I said NLT. And said to Archippus, be sure to carry out the ministry the Lord gave you. Okay, let me read the NIV version. Very powerful. It is one thing to have a purpose, or it is one thing to receive a purpose, and it is another thing to fulfill it. Tell Archippus, see to it that you complete the work you have received in the Lord. Now, in Colossians chapter 4 verse 17, Apostle Paul was talking about two things. Apostle Paul was talking about two things. The first thing is that see to it that you complete. I love that word. You complete. And the second thing is the ministry. Okay, go to King James. The ministry. Said to Archippus, take heed to the ministry which thou hast received in the Lord, that thou fulfill it. I love these two powerful words. Ministry and fulfilled. He was telling Archippus that, Archippus, you have received a ministry. You have received a purpose from the Lord. But see to it that you fulfill what? That purpose. See to it. So it is one thing to do what? To receive a purpose. And it is another thing to fulfill it. Another thing to fulfill it. See to it that you fulfill the ministry you have received. You have received from the Lord. Two things, very powerful. Very powerful, two things. Ministry and what? Fulfillment. So if you have received a ministry, or you have received, if you have received a ministry, beloved, you must make sure you fulfill that ministry. Oh, I thought somebody would shout amen here. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Archippus received a purpose from the Lord. He received a ministry from the Lord. But Apostle Paul was reviving him. He was preaching to him that he should see to it that he fulfill that ministry. And beloved, listen to me. A lot of people have received ministry or purpose from the Lord, but how to walk in the ministry or in the purpose and complete it, it's a problem. It's a problem. A lot of people in this generation have received a purpose or a ministry from the Lord, but how to walk in the purpose and complete it is a problem. It's a problem. Now, if you are here and you have received a purpose or you have received a ministry from the Lord and you want to complete it, then I am here to give you a key that will help you to complete or fulfill or finish the purpose or the ministry that you have received from the Lord. And beloved, that key is prayer is one of the greatest keys that can help a man to fulfill his assignment on earth. Prayer is one of the greatest keys that will help a man to fulfill his assignment. And listen to me, without prayer, nobody on this earth, no Christian can fulfill his assignment or her assignment on earth without prayer. I am telling you, I don't know how you will take it, but I know what I'm saying. I've studied the Bible for some time and I've come to understand that without prayer, nobody on this earth can finish his assignment on earth without prayer. Now, when you study the Bible very well, you see that Jesus Christ received a ministry from his Father. Jesus Christ received a purpose from his Father. And his ministry was that he will bring salvation to the children of God, or he will bring salvation to mankind. His ministry was that he will restore the dominion that man lost back to mankind. That was his ministry. Now, when you read the Bible in the book of Luke chapter 4 verse 18 to I think 19, Luke chapter 4 verse 18 and 19, the Bible says that after Jesus Christ fasted 40 days and 40 nights, the Bible says he returned in the power of the Holy Ghost. And the Bible said that he went to Nazareth. Makusihatai. He came to Nazareth, and in Nazareth, the Bible said he went to the synagogue. The Bible said that when Jesus Christ went to the synagogue, the Bible says that they gave him the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Bible said that he opened the book and he found the place where it was written that the Spirit of God is upon me. He received a ministry from the Lord. He said, for the Spirit of God is upon me. He has anointed me to preach the word to the poor. That is one. Preach the word to the poor. Two, to heal the brokenhearted. Three, to preach deliverance to the captives. Four, to heal the blind. Five, to set free those who are downtrodden. And the last one, he said, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. So Jesus Christ, when he came to this end, his Father gave him a ministry. And his ministry was to do what? Preach the word to the poor, heal the blind, set free those who are downtrodden, and proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord. Other version will tell you, and proclaim the favor of God. And proclaim the favor of God. Jesus Christ, his Father gave him a ministry. His Father gave him a purpose. Now, when you study the Bible very well, you see that when Jesus Christ began ministry, the Bible says that Jesus Christ came to understand, or Jesus Christ realized that the hearts of men are full of evil. The hearts of men are full of evil. Beloved, listen to me. I'm talking to you this morning on the topic prayer. Prayer, the key to fulfilling your purpose. Prayer, the key to fulfilling your purpose. And I'm telling you that without prayer, nobody, no Christian on this earth can fulfill his assignment or his ministry or his purpose on this earth. I'm telling you. Oh yes. Jesus Christ received a purpose, a ministry from his Father. But Jesus Christ realized that the hearts of men are full of evil. Now, when you read the Bible in the book of Luke chapter 4, Matthew chapter 9, verse 4. And Jesus knew. And Jesus, knowing their thoughts, said, "Wherefore think ye evil in your heart?" Okay, let me read the NIV version. NIV. Knowing their thoughts, Jesus said, "Why do you entertain evil thoughts in your heart?" In your heart. Okay, NIV, NLT version. NLT. Jesus knew what they were thinking. So he asked them, "Why do you have such evil thoughts in your heart?" Why? Why? He realized that the heart of men were evil. The heart of men were what? Evil. And beloved, this is what is going on this earth. But listen to me. When Jesus Christ realized that the heart of men were evil, prayer helped him to overcome these people. Prayer helped him to fulfill or complete his assignment on earth. Oh yes. Oh yes. And beloved, don't forget this. Don't forget this. Every ministry has a betrayer, or every ministry has betrayers. Every institution has betrayers. Every leader has betrayers. Every company has betrayers. So if you are a leader and you are not careful, if you are a leader and you are not prayerful, I am telling you, the evil people around you or the betrayers around you will end your ministry. Oh yes, it happened to Jesus. Judas was in his life. Judas was in his life. But listen to me. Betrayers will not end well. That is one thing I know. Betrayers will not end well. Anyone or anybody that will try to betray you, that person will not succeed. I am telling you, if you have a covenant with God, that person will not succeed. They will not succeed. They will not succeed. Look at what happened to Judas. Look at what happened to the guy. He went to hang himself. He went to hang himself. Hey, betrayers will cry till they will die. Betrayers will go through hardship. But beloved, what I'm trying to tell you is that you must always stand on the platform of prayer. It will help you. It will help you. Listen to me. The reason why a lot, you see, most of the pastors are no more in ministry because of betrayers. Betrayers have, some betrayers have entered ministries. They have entered ministries. Entered ministries. Okay. Betrayers, one thing, they set confusion. Betrayers, they set confusion. I'm telling you today. They set confusion. Betrayers. They set confusion. They are there to set confusion. Betrayers are there to set what? Confusion. But beloved, listen to me. If you always cry unto God, you will not fall into temptation. Hey, betrayers will do so many things, but you will not fall into it. And that's the reason why Jesus Christ told the disciples, he said, "Watch and pray that you will not fall into temptation." So prayer is one of the heavenly prescriptions that prevents men from falling into temptation. It prevents men from what? Falling into temptation. Falling into temptation. Falling into temptation. Falling into temptation. Beloved, Israel, if you are a leader, you must be prayerful. If you are a leader, you must be prayerful. If you are a child of God, you must be prayerful. You must be prayerful because it will help your leadership mandate. It will help your leadership mandate. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. Sometimes I'll be in the office and the Lord will minister to me. This person is doing this. Be careful. This person is doing it. Be careful. Don't allow this person to get closer to you. This person is doing this and this and this and this and that. One day I was there and the Lord opened my eyes. I saw two people. They are still in this church. No. One is not here. One is not here. I was there, the Lord opened my eyes. And I saw these people when they were talking about me. They said a lot about me. They said a lot about my wife. They said a lot about some people in the church. The Lord opened my eyes. I saw everything. I heard everything they said. So one, I called one of the ladies and I said, "Come, I want to talk to you." The lady came and I'm in it and I said, "Yeah, two of it." I said, "Yeah, let me tell you one thing. Let me tell you one thing. Let me tell you one thing." I finally decided, "Papa, Waka, let me tell you one thing. Let me tell you one thing. Sir, dear, now, Bessa Waka, Papa, the lady needs your shame. Lady needs your shame. baby William Shin. A two man office, I'm a true saying, be their bottom up. The people around you may think that the fact that you are not talking means you don't know what they are doing. When you come to my office, you see it. The Lord ministered to me. The people around you may think that the fact that you are not talking means you don't know what they are doing. So I called the lady and I said, this date, the Lord opened my eyes. I saw you and this person, and I'm all discussing about me, my wife, and some people in the church. Now, and some are crying in me. And the lady began to cry. Oh, Susa, no, catch him, papa. Me, oh, honey, panic, yes, I'm in the bay. Or can't let you, Susa, no. Because of him, and some are coming from A to Z as a normal cannabis in a home. Oh, Punko to just say, office. And oh, Susie, no, what's here? Confronting me, panic, answer. Because you won't grow for me on my own. And yet, if you are here with you in 9 a.m. to grow, there are some things, what's here, I am true. But be careful, don't touch the anointed of God. Don't touch those who have the covenant with God. He said, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. Do them no harm. And I was there, the lady came to me, the other lady came to me and said, Papa, I want to talk to you. I said, come to the office. I sat down with the lady, and the lady began to cry. I said, Papa, Fachani, Eko Yesi, he says, oh, to me, because I'm not a popo. I'm not a popo. I said, okay, he said, Papa, say, me, you're born here, say, not see me. Oh, so, me, Papa, can I say, oh, sir, when you need, oh, sir, on your quarter, when you need, oh, sir, but you need, man, to me, Papa, and man, do the penetration because you need that, but you have to be vigilant about the people around you. You have to be vigilant because the Bible says, be vigilant, be sober, that first you as a runner, you're seeking whom to devour. Let me tell you what, you will see Satan with your naked eyes, but you will see the agent of the devil around you. Their attitude, I bet you say, they are from the devil. I thought somebody would shout amen here. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ, Judas was a betrayer in his life. He realized that the people, the heart of the people were full of what? Wickedness. Wickedness. You see, the Bible says that who gave himself for our sins, that he might deliver us from this present evil world. So, well, did not you want to see an echo of you, and yet, if you are not prayer for a beloved, the devil will end your destiny for free. The devil will end your children's destiny for free. The devil will frustrate you. The devil will make sure you will go through hardship. Say the Bible and see. Satan came to steal, kill, and to destroy. But Jesus Christ came that we will have life and have it more abundantly. So his mission on earth is to steal, kill, and destroy. So if you are not vigilant, if you are not prayerful, the devil will destroy your destiny. The devil will destroy your career. The devil will destroy your company. The devil will destroy your ministry. I'm telling you today. Jesus Christ went through this thing. Oh, yes. And you see, prayer helped Jesus to complete his assignment. Prayer helped Jesus to finish or fulfill his assignment on earth. Now, I want to give you 7 scriptures that shows that Jesus Christ was a prayerful person. It talks about the prayer life of Jesus. The prayer life of Jesus. Hey, the Bible says that Jesus Christ is the anointed one. He is the Son of the Most High God. But when Jesus came to this earth, Jesus fasted 40 days and 40 nights because of his ministry. Because of what? His ministry. Beloved, as you are sitting here, you have a ministry. You have a ministry, but you don't know. You have a ministry, but you don't know. Frederick, I have a ministry. You have a ministry. If you are an usher in your church, that is your ministry. If you are a manager in your company, that is your ministry. If you are a media, if you are a leader in the media department, that is your ministry. If you play instrument, that is your ministry. If you are part of the intersexes, that is your ministry. Anything that you are doing, beloved, it's that is the ministry God has given to you. But if you don't if you don't pray, the devil will enter ministry for free. And that is the reason why Apostle Paul told Archippus, he said, see to it that you fulfill the ministry you have received from the Lord. Beloved, it takes a lot for a man to fulfill his assignment on earth. It takes a lot. It takes a lot. It takes a lot. And today I'm talking about prayer, because prayer is one of the keys that will help you to finish your assignment. There are so many keys that will help you to finish your assignment. And one of the keys is what? Prayer. 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 Let me give you the seven scriptures. Very powerful. It talks about the prayer life of Jesus. The prayer life of Jesus. The prayer life of Jesus. Beloved, if only you will stand on your feet and pray continuously. Apostle Paul said it. He said, continue in prayer and watch in the same with thanksgiving. If only you will pray continuously, beloved, you will finish your assignment on earth. You will finish your assignment on earth. I want somebody to clap for Jesus. Okay, Luke chapter 3 verse 21, you can write them. It will help you. The prayer life of Jesus. He was surrounded by evil spirits, wicked people. But prayer helped him to finish his assignment, complete his assignment. Prayer. Don't underestimate the power of prayer. Prayer can take you where man cannot take you. Prayer can take you where knowledge cannot take you. Prayer can take you where certificate cannot take you. I am telling you. Luke chapter 3 verse 21. One day, when the crowds were being baptized, Jesus himself was baptized. As he was praying, the heavens opened. He was a prayerful person. The people being baptized, Jesus also being baptized. The Bible says that Jesus was praying and heaven opened. Beloved, one of the keys that will help you to receive an open heavens is prayer. I say, is what? I want to hear a voice. It's what? Prayer is one of the keys that will help you to experience an open heaven. The last time I said it here, Peter, the Bible says that Peter went to the housetop to pray. The Bible says when he finished praying, the Bible says he was hungry and he was waiting for the meal. But the Bible says that, and Peter fell into a trance. He fell into a trance. And the Bible says he saw heaven open. He saw heaven open. He prayed and he fell into a trance and he saw heaven open. One of the keys that will help you to receive an open heaven is prayer. And beloved, listen to me. When the heaven open on your life, that will be the end of frustration. When the heaven open on your life, that will be the end of struggling. That will be the end of the problem you are going through. I am telling you. You cannot experience an open heaven and remain the same. Jesus Christ prayed and the heaven opened. The prayer life of Jesus. Matthew chapter 14 verse 23. After sending them home, he went. Okay, but maybe I give me King James. And when he has sent the multitude away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray. And when the evening was come, he was there alone. Beloved, you need a personal prayer life. I say what? A personal prayer life. One day I was there and my father called me. That's my biological father. My biological father called me. Said, if you want God to use you mightily, if you want God to use you to change life and transform life, learn to pray alone. Learn to pray alone. Because listen to me, when you are alone, there are some things God will tell you. But when you are in the midst of people, there are some things you will not hear. I am telling you today, learn to pray alone. Learn to pray alone. And my father gave me all the scriptures I'm about to read. He gave me all the scriptures. The prayer life of Jesus. He was there alone. And when the evening was come, He was there alone. He was there alone. There are so many people. Almost all of them are sorry in Asia. Personal prayer life. Only be. But yes, when your personal prayer life, you spend time with God alone. You spend time with God alone. Sometimes you have to fellowship with the Holy Spirit alone. Apostle Paul said, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. You now and forever. So sometimes you have to position yourself to fellowship with the Holy Spirit alone. The prayer life of Jesus helped him to fulfill his assignment, complete his assignment on earth. Mark chapter 6 verse 46. And when he had sent them away, he departed into a mountain to pray. He departed into a mountain to pray. People will come and Jesus will preach the word. He will perform miracles. He will heal the sick. He will raise the dead. He will do so many things. But beloved, listen to me. After performing miracles, the Bible said, Jesus, no, no, go share baby. Because so the last time I said it, in this 21st century, most of the pastors spend 1 hour on one demon. Most of the pastors spend 2 hours on one demon because they don't have power. When you spend quality time with God, beloved, God will renew your strength. They that wait on the Lord, he said, he shall renew their strength. He said, when you faint in the day of battle, it means your strength is small. Your strength is small. Most of the pastors, one demon, they will spend hours. Are you? They will be shut. Sometimes they will pray and the demon will be. There are some demons, they are stubborn. I can't remember when I was in JSS. I lay hand on a lady. And a demon be started so manifesting. Kasafa le demon. To cast out demons. Hey, if your time is not up, beloved, don't lay hand on people. If your time is not up, Antibrakatosa. Say the Bible and see, Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. Who are you? Bible says, I'm not born naked. If your time is not up, beloved, if your time is not up, don't lay hands. Don't try. Two ladies in a yeah. Say 2 minutes for northern region. S U president in chair. Now me see me be chair me crunching power. Maybe so be a who S U president is powerful because it's three buttons. Beloved, listen to me. If you can speak in tongues, that doesn't mean you can cast out demons. Oh, should I say it again? If you speak in tongues, that doesn't mean you can do what? Cast out demons. You need special power to do that. I can cast out demons. Hey, the one of you say demons, they can speak in tongues. And then on the lady speaking in tongues, the lady was looking at me saying, I was like, wow. And then lady, demons, you can talk to them. The one of me see me flabby. Since then, and I meet Wastademia. Yeah, you're starting a program, you also mean lay hands. I will be making declaration the Holy Ghost will touch people. Because since I sat down and be sure young suckers here, I will lay in offense. Men lay hands, I just the Holy Spirit that cast out enemy. I'm telling you. Now you're poor Esu. Obia Kofie. Naka Esu president. And now Esu secretary. Any financial, then the agenda on the button say, yeah. Demon into free northern region. Demon, to hear will be all ministry much no akọ kwantinti akasti di mo enye wa na satan kwana me sachara ye nje yo because kwana ma ye di me se me ma Christo holy oh yes sacrifice for ni obi akam ya me se me so no be satan me nsue gra wo school and take at once me se ma sachara but yet that doesn't mean you can cast out demons. What you say? If you are quiet, doesn't mean you can preach. I am telling you. I call all your quiet. You know, obey my yes, president. I'm the administration minister. I mean, for Christ, me know me home. Me resign here. Me resign in 10 times. Me resign. A true SU, I'm not afraid. Then you phone me. No, I'm going to be preaching. No, I'm going to come. Often, you're going to be ready. I'm going to be ready. That time, me preach here. Me trust scriptures. Me in the home. Oh, God. Clap for Jesus. The Lord has been good. Though. The Lord has been good. Major 10 scriptures. Let me be genuine. Today I want to talk on the topic prayer. Matthew chapter 3, verse 3. No, maybe I'm ready. Maybe we are. Second scripture. Maybe me explain to you. Maybe I'm saying, lift up your hands and thank God. Any pattern I can't read him. Ya yet you say, Pia, demon in God. Ekobo 6. Obia friskumo. Scripture man, Gakrebia no before us, and I'm on point. Yes, your friend Baba, enter your weapon. Enter your weapon. Be better, my name, who said, and Nippam, you will be free as soon home over. I want to be a shame. Omuturan almost your motion shall soon see. Nay, your mobano. Shuffle, Cassidim on any affair, Bank of Then in time, me banny basco, no? Now, or your key, not your yet to be finding coffee to many tyrannies. I want to catch him, say about it. So, would you be free, Saturday, we moa? Because when Junior and yes, that we no but report to school Monday, and she should any Friday after school. Or mom calls you down. You have a report to us. Whoa, where we? It's no same separate. My bumper, your mama sweat, your baby, Timmy, Nayami, and baby, no more. Bible, who paid my baby. Jesus, my kind gentleman, I want to be say, and you'll be okay, Jesus, and you'll be too demon. I want to be who you say, and you'll be okay, Jesus, and the two Messiah read. I am telling you, a grace, and yet, yes, I am. I'm telling you. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. So most of the pastors in Israel, they will shout, ayo, but study the life history of Jesus and see. Study his ministry and see. Jesus will command the demon, come out, and the demon will leave. After 40 days and 40 nights, Jesus went to the temple. A demon was making noise. He said, come out, you demon. The Bible said, instantly the demon proceeded out. And the Bible said, those who were there, they said to themselves, what a word is this? For with power and authority, he commanded the demon, and the demon proceeded out. Jesus didn't say, Adia, Iko, Azini, Ima, Reke, Baya. Pastors, almost all my children say, more power. But if you are a prayerful person, the Holy Ghost will always empower you to destroy the plans of the devil. I thought somebody would clap. Mark, that is Mark chapter 6, verse 46. Luke chapter 6, verse 12. The prayer life of Jesus. Luke chapter 6, verse 12. Luke 6, 12. And it came to pass in those days that he went out into a mountain to pray and continued all night in prayer to God. It was a scripture that I'm reading. Look of your own time, not really. If you honor say, or bombaya no pa, if you honor Mosua, Bible so for share mountains on Unqua, Bible say, or Chawa and a trinity. Oh, it is no bombaya no pa, no bombaya daytime, or bombaya night. If you honor Moa and go for a miracle, you know, because she may be more than a papa and communicate. And communicate. And then, generation way, everyone is busy. We don't have time for the Holy Ghost. Listen to me. If you don't have time for the Holy Ghost will not have time for you. Those who have time for the Holy Ghost, they will make impact in this world. They will do what? They will make impact in this world. So the last time the Lord said to me, the voice of impact is made in my presence. The voice of impact is made in my presence. If you want to make impact with your voice, spend time with the Holy Ghost. all night in prayer to God. All night. The prayer life of Jesus. Mark chapter 1 verse 35. Mark chapter 1 verse 35. And in the morning. In the morning. And in the morning, rising up a great while before day. Ahimachu. It is Ahimachu service in the Jesus Christ. And in the morning, rising up a great while before day, he went out and departed into a solitary place and there prayed. The prayer life of Jesus Christ. Luke chapter 9 verse 18. And it came to pass, as he was alone praying, his disciples were with him, and he asked them, saying, whom say the people that I am? Sometimes he will pray with the disciples. Sometimes the disciples will be with him whilst he's praying. Sometimes he will be alone praying to God. The prayer life of Jesus. Last scripture, Luke chapter 5. And he withdrew himself into the wilderness and prayed. Hey, you were scriptures in prayer because in the radio, into me ready. The prayer life of Jesus. My beloved, the reason why I quoted all these scriptures is because I want you to know that Jesus Christ succeeded in his ministry. He fulfilled his assignment on earth because he was a prayerful person. Now, the last statement Jesus Christ said before dying on the cross is, "It is finished. It is finished." That was the last statement Jesus said before he died on the cross. "For it is finished." Let's read it. "It is finished." John chapter 19 verse 30. When Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said, "It is finished." And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost. Statement, "It is finished." Now, when you talk about finished, what is the meaning of the word finished in that context? If the Bible belongs to you, can underline the word finished in that context. The word finished in that context is from the Greek word tetelestai. I think this word is common. Tetelestai. What they tell you that a big crunch mean can't wait in here. The right word is tetelestai. Now, what is the meaning of the Greek word tetelestai? You can write them down. One, it means completed. The word tetelestai means completed. It also means accomplished. And it also means finished. So in other words, Jesus said, "I successfully completed the work I came to do. I successfully completed the work I came to do on the cross." He said, "It is finished." Then it means he fulfilled his assignment. He completed his assignment on earth because he was a prayerful person. Oh, those who are clapping, may God favor them. Tetelestai. He completed his assignment. And not only Jesus, Apostle Paul the Great, completed his assignment on earth because he was a prayerful person. Paul, beloved, you have a ministry, But you must see to it that you fulfill that ministry before you die. Paul the Great. Paul the Great. The man said, he said in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7. Very powerful statement. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7. I have fought a good fight. I have fought a good fight. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. He said, I have kept the faith. He finished his assignment. He completed his assignment because he was a man of prayer. He was a man of prayer. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, I think verse 17, give it to me if I'm correct. He said, pray without ceasing. Apostle Paul said it. Pray without ceasing. Pray without ceasing. Give it to me. I'm correct. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 17. He said, pray without ceasing. Pray without ceasing. Colossians chapter 4. Colossians chapter 4, verse 2. Continue in prayer and watch in the same with thanksgiving. That is Apostle Paul. Continue in prayer and watch in the same with thanksgiving. He was a man of prayer. He was a man of prayer. If you are not a prayerful person, you cannot fulfill your assignment on earth. You can't. You cannot complete your assignment, your purpose on earth. Apostle Paul said it. We will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word. Give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word. The Bible said that Paul and Silas were going to the house of prayer. They were going to the house of what? Prayer. They were going to do what? They were going to pray. He was a man of prayer. He was a man of prayer. When they locked Paul and Silas into prison, the Bible says that at midnight, they prayed and they sang a song of praises. Beloved, if you're not a prayerful person, you'll be stuck in life. If you're not a prayerful person, you'll be stuck in life. A lot of people are stuck in life because they are not praying. Beloved, if you pray continuously, beloved, I am telling you, you will progress in life. The devil will use to stop you. Your prayers can remove that thing. Any limit that they will set, that nobody in the family can cross that limit. If you're a prayerful person, beloved, you will cross that limit. You will cross that limit. You will cross that limit. I'm telling you. Hey, anything God has given to you, beloved, make sure you fulfill that thing. Make sure singing ministry, fulfill that ministry. Preaching ministry, make sure you fulfill that ministry. If you are part of the ushering department, make sure you fulfill your ministry. If you play instruments, that is your ministry. Beloved, I came today to preach to somebody that prayer is one of the greatest keys that can help a man to fulfill his assignment on earth. I pray to God that you will not fail in life. I pray that you will win the battles of life. I pray that in the name of Jesus, one day you will stand on your feet and said, I fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have finished my assignment on earth. That is my prayer to God for you. In the name of Jesus. Beloved, position yourself to pray. The last time I said it here, when you die, people will not talk about the fun you've had. People will talk about the impact you've made and the things you have accomplished. That is what people will talk about. Jesus Christ performed miracle 2,000 years ago. We are still talking about it. Apostle Paul performed miracles years ago, but we are still talking about it. Beloved, listen to me. When you perform or when you make impact today and you die, people will still talk about the impact. They will talk about what? The late South Africa president, the late Nelson Mandela, Mazuka Diatai. Hey, people still talk about the man. But the key impact on the generation, on the country. Hey, one day I was reading, let me read maybe about this man. Now, when I saw what kind of say or no, or back what they fear, I'm in the country, and your freedom, he's ready to do that. He's ready to do that. And then what we call, but South Africa, and we are seeing now, and that support Nelson Mandela team because of impact of the king was as so. Beloved, Mesre, will you see him? Mesre, Mesre, position was say asasi so wa pa no we be free asasi so wa kono e was say wo generation yet unborn it me pure man ka say na me na na ba bi wo ho me na na be me bi wo ho on the be yes say japade we ya e pua bisuan ni na e was say ye ka say papa e fa wo ho Mary said Mary said from he said Mary said all generations shall call me blessed. All generations shall call me blessed. And then Obia kasa Mary eye nshira because of say onu no wu Jesus. Mary be na no kan ye. All generations shall call me blessed. Beloved say wu na wo kwa generation yet unborn. E was on be kan say papa mo ho. On be kasa me na 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 me beto no na ye fre na so mesi no. No onye convince me. No onye obi opema. No onye sika patobo abrabo basa basa. E was on bi o ma no no mo kasa. Me na 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 me na na ba wo ba ye me na na bema. On de be ye chapati e wei. Ama ebusuani ni na. E si ye ye. Abesi emra ye wo mi. May that be your portion. I pray in the name of Jesus that may God favor you. May God open great doors for you. May the Spirit of God revive you. May you pray like never before. In the name of the Lord Jesus. I want somebody to clap for Jesus. Now stand up.